Falcon Heavy is back and more powerful than last year. If you didn't see the launch live, you really missed out. Falcon Heavy. 2018's Falcon Heavy launch was covered in the media more than any other launch since the last shuttle mission. That means photos. Lots and lots of epic photos. You ever wondered how photographers get so close to the rocket to take these compelling photos? The trick is, they actually aren't there. This year, I thought I would team up with a photographer whose work you've seen all over the internet. Go on a journey, step by step, see the behind the scenes process of how these amazing photos are captured. In this part one of two, we'll be going over the preparations required to photograph these epic beasts. So Ryan, what are we doing today?
We're shooting Falcon Heavy.
Nice, man. So this is your second time, right?
Yeah, second time shooting Falcon Heavy.
Are there any challenges in particular that come with photographing this particular rocket?
I think one of the challenges is the fact that it's a lot brighter than just a regular Falcon 9 rocket. So you got to compensate your exposures for the brighter engines on it.
Right. I mean, it's like literally three times brighter.
Yeah.
What kind of things are, based off of your experience from last year's launch, are you changing up for this year?
So something that's a lot different from my first time shooting it is the equipment I'm using. So last time I shot it, I used just two cameras. I set up a wide shot for having the horizontal integration facility in like the foreground and then having Falcon Heavy in the back. And then the other one was gonna be an engine shot, but the sound trigger I used on that one didn't fire the camera. So I only got the shots from that one spot.
So that must've been really disappointing.
Yeah. A little bit. Something I have different is I use my own sound triggers now. After that launch, me and one of my old robotics mentors got together and made something based off an already used design. Kind of took that design, made it our own, and made it a little bit better.
So we're going to dive into the sound triggers too, but you can't be there to take a picture of the rocket yourself, at least from that close of range,
right,
due to safety requirements that NASA has, which makes sense. You don't want to be right next to a bomb as it's going off, really.
Right.
Always a bad idea. How long does it typically take for that sound to reach the camera to begin triggering them?
The cameras are fairly close to the rocket, so my guess would be it almost be instant.
You're 19 years old, correct?
Yeah.
How long have you been doing this?
So I was 16 when I first started it, and then also 16 when I started my media company to keep doing it until now.
That's really incredible that you had that kind of motivation and perspective at 16 years old to just have a direction, knowing what you want to do. Because when I was 16, I was probably like most 16-year-olds, I was an idiot. How old were you when you first got accreditation to go film a rocket launch?
I was 16. This was before NASA like implemented the age restriction to 18, which followed like a few months after I shot one at 16.
Do you know why they started that age limit?
I don't know the exact reason, but I'm sure it had to do with someone under 18 doing something stupid on base or something.
So it wasn't you?
No. Okay. I didn't do anything dumb.
I imagine if it was you, they wouldn't be letting you back.
Right.
So
yeah. It's a big learning curve, setting up your cameras in like a certain amount of time and making sure everything's right for launch. Like, you make mistakes here and there. I went to an Antares launch in Virginia that I didn't actually launch when I was there. After we set up remotes, we got called back to pick up remotes because the launch is already scrubbed for it. I went back to my cameras and like one of them, I didn't even like turn on the sound trigger. So that one wouldn't have gotten anything. And the other one, I didn't even put the settings in correctly. I just made the dumbest mistakes I could have.
So great. So you use a sound trigger to trigger the camera to take photos of the launch.
Yep.
Can you show us the one that you have?
Yeah, so this is the one I use. It's kind of like just the size of my finger. It's just a small board that I made off a website with my old robotics mentor. We kind of worked through it together. You'd like choose the parts that you're going to use, give you like these white outlines for the parts. You like put them in and then solder them on. Right here is like the sensitivity knob. So you'd like turn this to be more sensitive or less sensitive. This is the microphone, which is pointed straight up because I did a bad solder job on that. And then it uses a 9-volt battery to power it.
Okay, so let's imagine that we're at Cape Canaveral right now getting ready to photograph a launch. At what point does NASA let you guys get close to the rocket and set up your cameras?
So it usually varies per launch. The last Falcon Heavy, it was 24 hours before launch. I'm kind of expecting the same thing for this one.
How many locations will they take you to set up remotes?
So for most launches from 39A, there are four. There's the one with the horizontal integration facility with the SpaceX logo on the side. There's two mounds inside the fence, and one's at like a 45 degree angle to the pad, and then there's another second mound that's like a 9 degree like face on view to the rocket. And then the third spot is like outside the fence down like a road a little bit. That's kind of like a in between angle between those two mounds.
So with this launch, what are you planning to do?
I think I might set up two on the first mount at that like the 45 degree angle facing the pad. One's going to be an engine shot, and then one's just going to be like a general wide shot to try to get the plume like rising behind the rocket, because Falcon Heavy kind of lets off a decent amount of exhaust, makes a lot of water vapor off the suppression system. I'll figure out what I'm doing with the rest of the cameras. I just know I have some, and I just have some like planning to do.
Are you going to attempt to try to capture anything with the landing?
I'm gonna be shooting from the NASA Causeway to take pictures of the landings. I've got like my just regular T6i camera, and then a 150-600 Sigma lens, and then like with a crop sensor, it's like 900 something millimeters.
So what are you trying to do with your photography in particular? I'm sure that certain photographers lean more towards certain practices to get the look that they're trying to achieve. What are you trying to do with your photos?
What I've like recently started doing is not only getting the close-up pictures that are kind of like becoming really popular right now, I'm going to kind of go for the wide shots that show more of like everything that's happening in the environment around the launch, and not only just the rocket launching.
Okay, man. Well, I'm really excited to see, you know, how things come together for you during this launch. Hopefully the weather works out. Hopefully all the technical stuff works out. I know we're going to be living it through your eyes. We'll be checking in with you on the ground, just seeing how progress everything is going. I'll leave it at that. Everybody, please check in for part two. And Ryan, before we go, can you please let everybody know where we can find you on the internet and where they can find your photos?
I post all my photos on Instagram at Arabsat Photo, and then I usually post updates of what's going on Twitter at Arabsat Photo. My media outlet on Facebook, Spaceflight News.
Well, links to all of those things are going to be in the description below. Ryan, thanks a lot for joining me today. Let's see what happens, and good luck shooting some rockets.
I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, guys, that's it. Hopefully Falcon Heavy launched today. Please subscribe so you don't miss part two of this series, and we'll actually see what Ryan walked away from with this launch and see if his plans actually work out. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys later. All right, bye.